Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at another type of acids and bases, and probably the most important of the three, Brønsted, Lowry. So here we're going to say it was in 1923 when Brønsted and Lowry developed a new definition for acids and bases. Arrhenius devised Arrhenius acids and bases near the end of the 1800s, and it was in the new century, 1923, where these two guys helped to make that definition a little bit better. We're going to say, according to their definition, an acid was considered to be a proton donor. And when we say proton, we mean H+. So this first definition still goes in hand with the Arrhenius definition, because the Arrhenius acid is something that increases H+ concentration when dissolved in water. Brønsted and Lowry still agreed with that. They said that, we agree, an acid should have an H+. Where they disagreed, though, Brønsted and Lowry didn't believe that a base needed an OH minus to be a base. What they said instead was, if the acid donates H+, then the base must accept the H+. So their new definition for a base was, bases are proton, which means H+ acceptors. So this is where they differed from Arrhenius. So what we're going to say here is, we're going to say, unlike acids and bases, for Arrhenius, these we could use in solutions that were not just made up of water. And we're going to say here, Arrhenius acids say they're H+, they increase H+. Brønsted and Lowry says they give H+. So both agree. So you can say that Arrhenius acids are Brønsted and Lowry acids. Now, we're also going to say here that according to Brønsted and Lowry, a base accepts H+. Why would a base accept H+? Because it has lone pairs or it has a negative charge. Something positive, something negative naturally are attracted to one another. This kind of goes in line with Arrhenius a little bit, because according to Arrhenius, we have to produce OH minus. OH minus is negative, so it could accept H+. So there's a little bit of disagreement, but also a little bit of agreement in terms of bases. Now we're going to say that Brønsted and Lowry acids and bases are always occurring in pairs, which we call conjugate acid-base pairs. And what you need to remember is that conjugate acid-base pairs differ by only one hydrogen. So a good example is we have H2O, we could have OH minus, we could have H3O plus. Here, these two are conjugate acid-base pairs. They're only different by 1H. Water has 2Hs, OH minus only has 1. And you're going to say that these two could be conjugate acid-base pairs as well. H3O plus has 3Hs, H2O has 2. They're only different by 1H plus. So that's what we mean by conjugate acid-base pairs.